Hello, my name is Shalini Rawat. Welcome to my life page. Today I'll talk about becoming a primary school teacher. I'll take you through the journey of making of a primary school teacher. I began my schooling from St. Mary's Convent School, Bijnor, and then I continued my 11th and 12th in a public school in Dayavati Modi Academy, Modipuram. My father had a transferable job, so we keep shifting from one place to the other. So I did my BSc from Meerut College and BEd from Lucknow University. I picked up my career in 1994, where my mother persuaded me to become a teacher. She inspired me to become a teacher and I continue till date. In 2010, while I was working, I realized that a post-graduation is a must for a teacher. So I did my MA from Meerut College again, privately. Let's start discussing what is teaching toddlers and the primary kids. When I say teaching small kids, I mean to say that we are dealing with 3+, those who go to the school for the first time. And one thing a teacher has to remember always, that she has to start at the grassroots level, where the earth is fresh. The child has a very limited world. It just restricts to himself, his family, and a little about himself. The vocabulary is limited, so the teacher has a great job to do. She has to equip the child with the 21st century skills, communication skills. She has to get into the all-round development of the child, giving IT information and, if I say, the best transformation of them. And with the little ones, one thing the teacher has to remember, that it is only experiential learning. You cannot teach child anything abstract. The child has to do and then learn. So experiential learning is something the teacher has to incorporate in her lesson plans in the class. Whether she's taking the class indoors or outdoors, the teacher has to keep in mind that the easiest way to keep that teaching or the lesson in their mind forever is learning by doing. Then the teacher should have a very good rapport with her students. She has to develop that trust with the child because she is doing multitasking in the class. She has to do multiple roles. She has to be a teacher, of course, and then she has to be a mother, she has to be a mentor, she has to be a friend, she has to at times work like a nanny also for them. So she has to have that bond of love and trust with the child. Another thing to keep in mind is that the teacher has to take the child gradually, step by step, from concrete to the abstract level. When we talk about developing numeracy and literacy skills, we start what the child can see. We start with audio and visual both, listening and responding both, LSRW, listening, speaking, reading and writing skill. But gradually, it has to be abstract in the mind. The child should be able to do all the calculations, all the thinking on his own and express it, whether it comes out in words on the paper or when he's communicating. Now, let's go a step further. Let me talk about the education that is required to teach small kids. The theoretical understanding of few topics is mandatory. One is child pedagogy,